Hello everyone, my name is Ravindranath Prasad Yadav. Today I'm going to talk about manufacturing process of terry towel. Firstly, I would like to tell you about the purpose and outcome. Terry towel is a daily use product like this. I was really very curious about the manufacturing process of this fabric. As you can see, the cross lining of the thread in different color patterns to make this fabric. It is very interesting. Terry towel was the most suitable product I have found. I would like to tell you why. Firstly, the word terry names comes from word tirer, which means to pull out, the threads pulling out. A terry towel is a textile product which is made with a loop pile on one or both sides covering the entire surface, forming stripes, checks or patterns. A towel is basically a piece of absorbent fabric or paper used for drying or wiping. Everyone uses towel after bath, after face wash, and we want our towel quality to be very good. It should be soft and it should absorb the water on the surface of your face or skin when we directly contact it, often using blotting or a rubbing motion. Common household textile towels are made from cotton, rayon, bamboo, non-woven fibers, or a few other materials. We have different types of towels. Baby towel, bar towel, beach towels, golf towel, hand towels, and hotel towels. Now I'll show you a towel worn by a baby. See, it's cute, right? Now I'll talk about the process and the flow chart of terry towel manufacturing. First, we have wrapping. Wrapping is nothing but the bending of the thread. The thread, you can see the thread, it gets bent on the other thread. This is a wrapping. Wrapping and weft are basic components used in weaving to turn thread or yarn into fabric. Like to show you a video. See, here one thread is getting bent with another thread. The color is your choice for the pattern you want. Also, another video for your interest. This is the old technique where using a wheel, we use the thread rolling on the wheel with different colors for different patterns. And also, I would like to show you the looming process. This is a looming machine. A loom is a device used to weave cloth and tapestry. The basic purpose of any loom is to hold the wrap threads, the threads over here, under tension to facilitate the interweaving of the weft threads. Now let's come back. We have the fabric inspection, red processing we'll be talking about next, and the inspection and the stitching of this threads, and the final inspection, packing and cartoning and shipment. What are the basic important properties of towel? To use a towel, the towel should absorb the water. It should be soft, and the heat insulation property. It depends on the thickness of the towel and the entrapped air. Fibers used in terry towels, it should be having following criteria. It should be highly absorbent, highly wet strength, ability to dye well, good color fastness, washability, softness, cost, availability. It should be available first thing. It should be less cost. And after washing, the color shouldn't fade away. You wouldn't like a towel you found which has a good pattern, which has a good color, but it fades away after first wash. Yarns using terry towel. I would like to show you the yarn machine first. This is a yarn machine, the pile yarn and the ground yarn. We have different types of terry towel yarns. Group warp yarn, the weft yarn, and the pile yarn. These parameters are the measurements, 20 by 2, 24 by 2, any count with 550 turns per meter. This is just for your information. Mechanism of pile formation. What is a pile? Pile is a surface effect on a fabric composed of infinite number of loops. There are infinite number of loops, you can't count, of wrap threads or infinite number of wither weft. What is weft and what is wrap? Over here, if you can see, this outer boundary loop, yellow and green, is a front side pile wrap. This is the bending of yellow thread on the green thread, cross-sectional in a cross pattern. And inside we have another loop, red and blue, with the first round wrap and the second round wrap. And the weft, these holes, tiny holes are the weft. The basic mechanism of terry towel lies in the formation of a loop of uncut pile. There can be pile either in one side or in both sides. The pile can be one side or in both sides. with different patterns with the cross section of a terry towel along a wrap, i.e. across the weft yarns. Which I should like to show you a picture of this. This lines, this is a towel wound with different pile heights. The wet process of terry fabric, desizing, scouring, bleaching, dyeing, finishing. We wouldn't talk much about this, but I would like to just name these processes. The yarn dyed towels may also be produced. Printing of towels may be also be done. The printing is a very good idea, as many customers would like to buy your towel seeing your patterns and designs. Coloration of terry towel, yarn package dyeing, and fabric printing. Dyeing towel fabrics, commonly used dyes, reactive dyes. Commonly used machine, winch, jet, soft flow, overflow. Pad path, pad steam, fabric in open pit form. Chemical finish. Chemical finishing is very important for your hygiene purpose and the towel's finishing. Enzymatic softening, antimicrobial treatment, if not inherently antimicrobial fiber use. It goes under a large tanks. I would show at the end of this video how it is happening. Finishing towel fabrics. Mechanical finishing, tumble drying, gives softness, fullness, and fulfillness, fluffiness. And finally, I would like to show you the final video. The threads coming out and it becomes like this. This is weaving happening. The threads getting cross-linked with another thread, weaving and weft. And later, today's era, we have machines which can do weaving, which are earlier done by the charkas or wheels. Now, this is the chemical process I was talking about in the large containers. Flushed out, and then the final towel you're getting. Thank you.